The first thing that we have to do is to remove the plastic cover. The next thing that we have to do is to remove the supercharger belt. For this we have to use 17 mil and locker pin. Now the tensioner is fixed. I have to remove the thermostat housing bolt, this one. I have to clean this thread here, down here. Let's remove the bolt. After I cleaned this thread and this bolt here, down here, was removed, I'm ready to install the kit. This is the kit. It's actually 3 years old. I'm using it for almost 3 years. It's still like new. This is the bolt that I need. I have to install it in this way. And this thing is very important. And this bolt goes here. Let's install the kit. First we need to put this thing down here. After that we have to put this bolt with the washer. And very very important step is to install this sleeve. Now you can see the sleeve and the bolt with washer. They have to go to the thermostat housing hole. We have installed this bolt. Has to be finger tight at this moment. I have to finger tight the other bolt. For the other bolt I have to use 10 mil socket. It has to be torqued. Now the bolts are finger tight. I have to use a torque wrench to torque them correctly. I have to torque the smaller bolt with 14 Newton meters. The larger bolt needs to be torqued with 15 Newton meters. I'm using 15 mils socket. At this point we have to install a new belt, which is 70 to 80 millimeters longer than the previous belt. And we have to release the tensioner. That's it, the installation is complete. The main advantage of this, we can remove and change the accessory belt without removing the wrap kit. And the other advantage is that the wrap kit pulley, this thing, is a standard part that can be replaced in case of failure. It's one thing that I forgot to show you. The thermostat housing pipe is really close to the bracket. And in case that the bracket and the thermostat housing are in contact, you have to file some of this material here. Just the edge, nothing else. And the final detail.